Ah, there you are. And here we go. It's time for the Pipewriter Show. Welcome back, everyone. We are smoking a Savinelli, Ginger's favorite, with some Cornell and Diehl, corncob pipe, and a button nose. This is actually my first time smoking this pipe, and I have to say, it's pretty amazing. In this episode, I wanted to discuss playing favorites. Pipe favorites, that is. I know many of you out there have a favorite pipe or pipes, but for some of us, ranking our pipes or coming up with a pipe pecking order is an almost impossible task. Many of us love all of our pipe children equally, and why not? They're all unique, all have their good sides and bad sides, and all are filled with a certain amount of unpredictability that's fairly consistent with human nature. No matter how well you think you know a pipe, sometimes a pipe can surprise you. It could be the pairing with a certain tobacco that opens up your eyes to a whole new experience of pipe smoking that went previously unnoticed. Or perhaps after not smoking a certain pipe for a while, it's almost like you rediscovered your love of it all over again, or rekindled a long-lost friendship. And that's one of the things I really appreciate about most pipes and pipe smoking. There's really no need to have a favorite or to play favorites, because that briar bullseye will continue to move as long as you've got fluid in your lighter and some tamp left in your tamper. And just one of the many reasons that I'm partial to Savinelli pipes is because they play favorites for me beautifully. I now own 5 of their favorites. 2 Bing's favorites named after Bing Crosby, a Clark's favorite named after Clark Gable, and 2 Ginger's favorites named after a famous ginger. However, it's a bit of a mystery as to just who the ginger in question really is. Most think this beautiful pipe is a tribute to dancer Ginger Rogers, while others say it's a tribute to Cream drummer Ginger Baker. And there are even some out there that say the pipe is a tribute to Ginger from Gilligan's Island. I just got this smooth 104 version of the Ginger's favorite line, and have to say it's an extremely elegant pipe and smokes as beautifully as Ginger Rogers moved around the dance floor. It's also in that almost long enough, but not quite long enough to be a church warden category. Almost the perfect length for a 3-hour tour. And you have to admit, it's a really cool-looking pipe that would be befitting a famous rock and roller and well worthy of groupies. Forgive me, it's time to relight the Ginger's favorite. So just who the ginger is remains a bit of an unsolved mystery. But if there are any Savinelli sleuths or Robert Stack wannabes out there with any definitive evidence, please let me know. But for now, I'm enjoying a little bit of mystery with this pipe. I'm also enjoying letting Savinelli play favorites for me, so that I don't have to. Because let's face it, every pipe is a pipe worth smoking. And here's why. Because anytime you're sitting down, relaxing with the pipe, and see the smoke dancing in front of your eyes, it's as if the rest of the world slows down a bit. Your mind travels to far-off places where your troubles seem a little less troubling. And in those moments, you find an appreciation for things in your life that so often go unappreciated. And as the smoke clears, so too does your outlook on life. You find a reason to smile. You gain perspective that wasn't there before. And you see a hope-filled horizon that guides you toward the most important thing that there is to find in life, true happiness. Those are my favorite moments, so there's really no reason for me to play favorites with my pipes. And just so you don't think I'm playing favorites now, I wanted to show you my other Ginger's favorite. This is the 626 bent apple version in the rusticated finish, where there's a sleekness and a bit of refinement to the 104. This 626 has a curviness and sturdiness in hand that make it every bit as special as its sister. Or is it a brother? Well, we never really know for sure. So there you have it. Until next time, remember to smoke slow, type fast, and live every moment like it may be your last. So long, everyone.